This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 20 races to bring you, all of them in the six-figure category. We're going to start at Laurel, where they have transplanted the old Colonial Downs Stakes races. This is the former Virginia Oaks, now the Commonwealth Oaks.
And they're off in the Commonwealth Oaks. A deep outside, Heart of Midway is speeding up there. Gypsy Judy, Miss Ballistic down to the inside, is up close too. Here's Onus taking a spot just to the outside and in the clear now as Miss Ballistic is taken back in that fourth position. And they're followed up by Ortega, who's racing along in fifth of the first turn run. And back to Toda Jika, who's placed mid-pack early in the two-path. And the inside is Lola Bo. Stormy Regatta just in behind that group on the inside. Here's Zvarkova lingering third last early in the race. And Reina Dabateria, and last is Red Sachet. 10 lengths will cover the field. 24 seconds at opening quarter mile. So Heart of Midway from that outside post is over to lead the way. On the rail out at 70 feet by a half length in front of Gypsy Judy in second. 2 lengths back, Onus is racing in third and perched for a run. A length and a half more, Miss Ballistic as Lola Bo is saving ground as they head on to the far turn run. Ortega's on the outside within 5 lengths of the pace up ahead. Then Stormy Regatta followed by Toda Jika, who's next, and Reina Bateria, and it's Zvarkova, who's about 9 from the front and trying to move on out 3 wide around that far turn run and Red Sachet trails. 24 seconds, the opening quarter, 48.4 was the half mile, the 6-1, 12 3/5 of a second. So Heart of Midway has controlled it so far. Gypsy Judy's been in close attendance to the pace in second, but now Forrest Boyce says, go on Onus, and Onus sweeps up on the outside, and Onus up to challenge for the lead at the 3/16 pole. Onus now taking off to that final furlong. For in between horses, Stormy Regatta's trying to kick in very late. Lola Bo's off the inside, but Onus sharp once again in the Commonwealth Oaks. It's all Onus. Oh, Onus, very impressive to win by 5 going away. Photo for second as Stormy Regatta, Reina Dabateria's in there, and Lola Bo.
Onus, love the name. Forrest Boyce is having a very good fall meet at Laurel. Takes the mount for Mr. McGahee, the 2-1 second choice in the wagering. Scores the victory, returning $6.80. Lola Bo finishes second. Stormy Regatta finishes third in this year's Commonwealth Oaks. Headed down to Remington Park in Oklahoma, where they had a big, big Sunday afternoon of racing. We have 4 stakes races to bring you. Up first, the Remington Green Stakes.
They're off in the Remington Green. Code West launches away, has the early lead to Cleto Red inside right there from the outside. Gaining ground now, War on the home front and Cougar Ridge running fourth as they leave the chute. Down the chute, it's Ish Rules, a length better than Green Grass of Wyoming. Class President trails already almost 10 lengths behind as they go to the main oval. It's a Cleto Red on the lead now by a length as they pass the line. War on the home front is second, Code West third. After that is Cougar Ridge tracking along fourth, 5 from the front. Then Ish Rules at the rail going to the clubhouse turn. Green Grass of Wyoming, nothing yet, is sixth. 3 clear, Class President, still about 9 from the lead. Opening quarter in 24 1/5 seconds as they move to the back stretch. And a Cleto Red continues to show the way by a good length over War on the home front. In those shiny gold silks, Code West tracks along third, a length and a half better than Cougar Ridge. Ish Rules picks things up fifth, getting closer now up the back stretch. Still back is Green Grass of Wyoming, last year's winner, now beginning to join the company up front. The back is still Class President. Again, 8 lengths from the front, 47 4/5 for the half miles. They go to the far turn. All the Cleto Red so far. Code West is right behind a Cleto Red, ready to go with 3 furlongs left as they go to the turn. War on the home front is clear, second to the outside. And rolling, here comes Green Grass of Wyoming, fourth and advancing 3 wide. Cougar Ridge is trapped in there, fifth. Ish Rules still at the back, Class President. Quarter mile to go, 6 furlongs in a minute, 11 2/5, and a clear red trying to hold on. But here's the company, Greengrass Wyoming, sweeps by, and Cougar Ridge now is clear and full of run with a furlong to go in the green. It's Greengrass Wyoming, Cougar Ridge way out in the middle, grabs the lead now. Inside Code West is sleeping and sneaking through, but Cougar Ridge will prevail by a little more than a length. Code West tried to sneak by, got there for second. Greengrass Wyoming third. Ish Rules up for fourth.
Cougar Ridge scores the victory, the third choice in the wagering. You see the first three choices in inverted order on the string. CJ McMahon, who's had a tremendous meet at Remington Park, he gets the stakes winning victory for Randy Morris. He returns $7.60. Code West finishes second. And the 2-1 favorite, Greengrass of Wyoming, finishes third in the Remington Green. Now to the sprint, where we saw over 80% of the show money on the favorite. This is the Remington Park Sprint. Ivan Fall off a lot, the 1-5 favorite.
They're off the Remington Park Sprint Cup. Bagged away sharply. Also right there, Can Dip goes for the front. It's Can Dip by a bobbing nose over Home Run Birdie. Ivan Fall off a lot, position third under Burrell. A length and a half back and a length and a half clear of Bag O'Day. Outside fifth, that time a hit, inside of the blue. Ibaka, gap of four more to the trailing Hollywood Mischief. Seven from the front with a half mile to go, opening quarter mile in 21 4/5 seconds. Can Dip nose to nose with Home Run Birdie as they approach the turn. Staying wide but clear is Ivan Fallen off a lot with 3 furlongs to go. Third and quickly approaching the leaders. I'm a hit now moving wide in fourth. Bag O'Day is fifth. Well back to Ibaka and Hollywood Mischief. Three wide at the quarter pole, and Ivan Fallen off a lot. Just sidles on to the front. Has the lead, top of the stretch. Inside Can Dip. Here's a big run from I'm a hit moving into third. Top of the stretch in the Sprint Cup. Ivan Fallen off a lot. Looking sharp to support the backers at this point. Up by almost three with a 16th to go. Can Dip is next. I'm a hit. Bag O'Day all out to try to catch some minor rewards. Ivan Fallen off a lot to win the Sprint Cup by 3 lengths and sweep the Sprint Stakes Series this year at Remington Park. Can Dip was second. Photo coming up for the show. I'm a hit in Bag O'Day.
Calvin Burrell sitting on a Cadillac, no trouble here, stays out of trouble the entire way, wins by 2.5 lengths, returns the popular $2.40, and as you heard on the race, sweeps the major sprint races at Remington Park. Can Dip finishes second. I'm a hit, well, not quite enough, finishes third in the Remington Park Sprint. Continuing on with the dirt stakes action, we have the fillies in the Remington Park Oaks.
They're off in the Remington Park Oaks. Tasha Talaferro goes right to the front, there by a length early on over Page and Sweet Opportunity. Harlan's Romance outside moves up fourth, down at the rail of the gray. That's Rose to Glory. Then the big closer, Include Betty, at the back where she's comfortable early, almost 10 lengths out of it. Into the clubhouse turn. Tasha Talaferro shows the way by a couple of lengths now. Outside, Sweet Opportunity is second. Page in the green. Third, three off the lead. Harlan's Romance is fourth and wide going to the back stretch. Rose to Glory, comfortable fifth. Include Betty, again, 10 lengths back. The trailers, they go to the back stretch after an opening quarter mile and an easy 24 2/5 seconds. Tasha Talaferro setting a slow pace, leads by 2.5 with 5 furlongs left. Sweet Opportunity, tracking second. Page now with company. Harlan's Romance to the outside under a tight hold. De Grey, Rose to Glory. Vasquez has a ton of filly, trying to save that for later on with a half mile to go. Include Betty beginning to creep up a bit, only about 8 lengths off the lead. Half mile went in 49 seconds and change. So a tactical pace up front by Tasha Talaferro and CJ McMahon into the final turn. Here's Sweet Opportunity now, rolling up second, beginning to make a bed. Harlan's Romance is third and wide, and Include Betty has left the back, and she's coming on. She is 5 wide, but she's coming after the leaders with a quarter mile left. 4 wide off the rail, top of the lane. Race on in the Oaks. Include Betty outside. Harlan's Romance, Sweet Opportunity, and Tasha Talaferro, and Include Betty strikes the front with a furlong left. She's up by a length and now being asked. Harlan's Romance getting crowded a bit with Sweet Opportunity. It's Include Betty down the lane trying to hold off Sweet Opportunity, who has something left in the tank. And Include Betty will prevail in the Oaks by a half length over a tough run with Sweet Opportunity. Harlan's Romance was third. Rose to Glory, their fourth.
Include Betty, recently seen in the Alabama Stakes, running ambivalently. But Tom Proctor goes out, to Remington. The 3-10 favorite from last to first by half a length with Drayden Van Dyke, who had a fantastic weekend in the saddle. Include Betty returns $2.60. Sweet Opportunity finishes second. And the longest shot on the board, Harlan's Romance at 25-1, finishes third. And wrapping up the stakes action at Remington Park, the old Remington Derby, now the Oklahoma Derby.
They're off in the 27th Oklahoma Derby. Shotgun Cowboy, Desert Dynamo, and Hillbilly Royalty weigh best from the outside. Down inside, both Poseidon's Way and Lucky Player, Super Colossal, is also in the early mix as they pass the line first time. Shotgun Cowboy gets over to safe ground and has the advantage by Bobby Nose with Classy Class now in the mix. Outside, Hillbilly Royalty three wide into the first turn. Poseidon's Way inside of Super Colossal between runners. That's Desert Dynamo, very close, sixth. Around the first turn, Witch Six is outside of Lucky Player. Gap of another length to Bold Conquest and Mobile Bay. Five more lengths then to The Truth or Else. And Taylor Verve, the trailer, 12 off the lead, opening quarter mile in 22 4/5 seconds. It's Classy Class, now by a head over Shotgun Cowboy. Hillbilly Royalty, right there in the mix, three wide, a very close third. Super Colossal tracks fourth, half length better than Poseidon's Way. Then Desert Dynamo, sixth. Lucky Player moving along inside. Outside is Bold Conquest, Witch Six now emerging through traffic, half mile to go. The opening half one in 46 4/5 seconds. Mobile Bay is wide, but beginning to pick things up. Then Taylor Verb, The Truth or Else, still at the back. Shotgun Cowboy wants the lead back and will take it with 3 furlongs to go in the Oklahoma Derby. Classy Class still there, third still, Hillbilly Royalty. Super Colossal is just waiting for a spot to go, trapped inside Poseidon's Way. Wide and rolling, both Desert Dynamo and Bold Conquest. Mobile Bay chasing them, quarter mile left after 6 furlongs. In a minute, 11 3/5, Shotgun Cowboy. The Oklahoma bred has the lead by 2 as they straighten away. Here's Desert Dynamo chasing second, outside to Mobile Bay, then Bold Conquest at the 16th. Shotgun Cowboy is all out to fend off Desert Dynamo, who's creeping up with every stride. Oklahoma Derby won for the second time by an Oklahoma Red Shotgun Cowboy by a half length over Desert Dynamo. Mobile Bay was third, photo for fourth.
Shotgun Cowboy. Clifton Berry in the saddle, the 5-2 favorite, scores the victory by half a length. Just about on the pace the entire way. Returns $7.60. Should say the pace setter nearly the entire way. Returns $7.60. Desert Dynamo finishes second. Mobile Bay finishes third in this year's renewal of the Oklahoma Derby. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, opening weekend at Santa Anita's Fall Meet.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
I'm Steve Beck.
And I'm Seth Merrill.
Together, we're Loose on the Lead on Capital OTB, Sundays at 10 a.m. Why should they watch, Seth?
Sit down on Sunday, have a bagel, get some great racing conversation.
Cream cheese only, no jelly. Sundays, 10 a.m., Loose on the Lead, Capital OTB.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV, Digital Channel 8.2. Delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world, whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita racecourses, no other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Digital Channel 8.2.
Face it. Most horse racing websites are just too much. Too much clutter. Too much to navigate through. Next time, log on to CapitalOTB.com. Our newly designed website is easier than ever to use, with all the information the professional horse player needs. CapitalOTB.com.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Saturday afternoon was opening day at Santa. They had 6 stakes races on the card. We're going to start down the hill in the Unzip Me.
And away they go. Will it be able to come out well? Elementar is setting off for the early lead. Spirit of Gian on the far side. On the inside, Finest City now sprinting up to make it three in a line. Here's Desert Steel getting a good spot right behind the leaders, and Singing Kitty in the blue cap on the far side. They followed by Curlin's Fox, who's no more than four off these leaders. Then comes Moons Over Me and Ultimate Holiday, the early trailer. Eight lengths covers them all. Half mile to run, and Elementar's in front just under a length. Spirit of Gian traveling well in the second spot. Those two come down the hill in front. In behind that comes Finest City in the black colors. On the far side, Singing Kitties in a striking position. On the far side, Ultimate Holiday in the red cap is improving. Desert Steel has lost some ground at the rail. Curlin's Fox in the gold cap, and Moons Over Me is last. They're at the top of the lane, and Elementar is now tackled by Spirit of Gian, and Spirit of Gian goes on for home. Here comes Singing Kitty on the outside. Desert Steel getting blocked on the inside. Coming with a late run, Curlin's Fox. But it is now Singing Kitty. Singing Kitty now gets the lead with 50 to go. Singing Kitty in front. And Singing Kitty and Rafael Bejarano have won the unzip. The Spirit of Gian had to settle for second. Curlin's Fox was third, and then Finest City.
Singing Kitty at nearly 10-1 for Rafael Bejarano scores the victory, returning $21.40, defeating Spirit of Gian. And the 4-5 favorite, Curlin's Fox, finishes third down the hill in the Unzip May. Fifth race on the card, the Old Norfolk Stakes, two-year-olds going a mile to 16th in the front runner.
And away they go, and Nyquist hopped out of there very smartly. But it's Go Long who wants the lead. Go Long sent along from the inside gate, going to be joined now by Mount Vida. Nyquist up between those two, the three of them ensuring a good early pace. Blame It on the Law takes back into the four spot. Swipe in the green, oh, going wide into the turn here was Go Long. Go Long went a little wide into the turn. Then we come back to Swipe racing in the fifth spot. In behind that is Hollywood Don, taking a nice oldie, six lengths off the leaders. Been followed then by Rare Candy, second last, and another four back to On Fire. Got to be a good 15 off the lead. Down the back stretch they go, and Go Long has ensured a good early pace, leads at a half a length. Nyquist is right there second, Mount Vida's on the far side. Blame It on the Law comes through in the rail and the white colors, only two lengths off the lead now. Between them is Swipe, who's pretty keen to go on. They're all bunching up front. In behind them comes Hollywood Don, continues to travel well, four lengths off the leaders. On the far side comes Rare Candy, and then a big gap of five back to On Fire. So they've taken much closer order now with 3/8 to go. It is Go Long at the rail, but Nyquist now breathing down his neck, and Nyquist goes looking for the lead. Mount Vida running a big one in the gold on the far side. In behind that comes Swipe on the inside of them. It's Blame It on the Law on the far side. Coming with his run now is Hollywood Don. Hollywood Don set sail after the lead as they come for home. Mount Vida, Nyquist is fully stretched. Swipe down at the rail. Hollywood Don chasing after them in fourth, and then Rare Candy, homeward bound Nyquist, Swipe at the rail. Swipe is coming fast. Nyquist calls on all his class. They hit and head for the wire. Nyquist was all heart, and Nyquist won it. Swipe was second. Hollywood Don settled for third. Rare Candy finished fourth.
Nyquist, ladies and gentlemen, who won the Del Mar Futurity for Doug O'Neill a couple hours after Doug O'Neill won the Hopeful Stakes for the historic day. Folks, at the half-mile poll, I would have given you 5-1 on the 1-2 favorite, but Nyquist scores the victory by 3/4 of a length, defeating Swipe. Hollywood Don finishes third. The offspring of Uncle Mo adds to his impressive resume and goes forward as probably one of the choices, and I don't know if he'll be the favorite, because we see in just a moment, the girls went faster than the boys in the juveniles. Up next, a true treat in this sport, Fillies or mares in the Grade 1 Zenyatta.
Goes straight in, gates closed, they're all set. And away they go. Beholder got a good enough break from the outside, but is fanned wide in the early stages. My Sweet Addiction is right there, and Wild in the Saddle in the white cap. Then My Monet, Kiriaki in the white cap, moving up a little closer. Beholder caught about five wide into the turn. Now probably going to have to drop in behind, although still wide as they pass the 7/8. Big Book behind that. Then comes Warren's Vanita. And last of all is Savings Account. Eight lengths covers them all. Onto the backstretch they go, and Mike Smith has taken My Sweet Addiction along at a good pace, leads it a length and a half. Wild in the saddle is second, My Monet down at the rail. Beholder in the orange cap on the far side. Beholder now running up to take the third spot, just two off the leaders. Kiriaki's right there, fifth. Then comes Warren's Vanita in the red blinkers, four lengths off the leaders. Behind that Big Book and Savings Account trails, seven covers them all. Past the half mile they go, and Beholder's now turning the pressure on. Beholder on the far side, My Sweet Addiction at the rail. They stride for stride with 3/8 to go. Then My Monet, Kiriaki behind that, Wild in the saddle, losing ground. Warren's Vanita still far back. They are coming towards the quarter pole now, and Beholder now takes the lead. And Beholder goes on for home. My Sweet Addiction tries to hang tough. My Monet is back in third at the top of the lane, and it's all Beholder. Gary Stevens has not asked her, now takes a look over his shoulder at My Sweet Addiction. Now a look over his right shoulder, but Beholder once again is just making this look so easy. It is Beholder in an absolute canter, being geared down late by Gary Stevens. Beholder in a formality. My Sweet Addiction second. Then came Savings Account, close Big Book, and My Monet. Warren's Vanita behind them, Wild in the saddle, and Kiriaki was last.
I have mentioned this before, and when she won the Pacific Classic, I think it is about to come true. For the first time in the history of the Eclipse Award, a distaffer will win a two-year-old, three-year-old, and handicap championship, joining the likes of Seattle Slough, Affirmed, and Spectacular Bid. That is Beholder. Not much in the Zenyatta for her to worry about. You can see Gary Stevens was comfortable being wide throughout on the 1-10 favorite, the only single-digit odds on the board. Her ears were pricked perfectly. She wins by 3 1/4. She shortens up for 10 furlongs, and rumor has it she'll be extending back to 10 furlongs after this victory in the Zenyatta. That's three in a row victories in this race. My Sweet Addiction finishes second, who Mike Smith did everything he could do to try and upset the apple cart. Savings Account finishes third. Now time for the two-year-old fillies in grade one action at Santita the Chandelier.
And away they go. Songbird broke away smoothly in the red cap and is setting off straight for the lead. So Songbird going to make her own pace out here. Halo Darling down at the rail. Yodel Song right there. VAR Luna between them. Land Over Sea on the outside. The horses are in tight here. A little bit of pushing going on in the second flight. Jade Princess on the far side going up to be second. In behind those we have She's a Milky Way. And right at the back here was Right There. Right There took a few awkward steps into the turn. Looked like she might have been eased, but she is continuing but last. On to the backstretch they go, and Mike Smith has the favorite, Songbird, beautiful and relaxed out here. Songbird just on a long rein takes them along by a length and 3/4. Jade Princess tracks from second, Land Over Sea in third. Halo Darling at the rail, five off the leader. Then comes Yodel Song. Behind that, Vieja Luna gives them 10 length start. She's a Milky Way next, and last of all is Right There. They head past the 3/8 pole now, and it's Songbird still well clear out here. Songbird has the lead by 4. Land Over Sea comes to try and make a race of it now, and Land Over Sea making a little headway on Songbird with 1/4 mile to go. Then comes Jade Princess. The others of no consequence. They come to the top of the lane, and Songbird, Mike Smith, hasn't moved on her yet. Land Over Sea still gritty from second, is coming to make a race of it. Homeward bound Songbird now just gets the rain shaking at her, and Songbird goes on gamely. Very game run from Land Over Sea, but the fact is Songbird is just plain too classy. It is Songbird, the daughter of Adalio Doro, in another scintillating performance today. Songbird in a romp. Land Over Sea a game second. Right There somehow came on to finish third. Vieja Luna was fourth.
This is the old Oakleaf Stakes, ladies and gentlemen, and the 1-5 favorite for Jerry Hollendorfer, the Familiar Silks of Fox Hill Farms, ridden by Mike Smith. The offspring of Medaglia d'Oro goes to the front, makes every pole a comfortable winning one. Very, very impressive in this score. Songbird remains undefeated now. I think that's 3 for 3. Wins by 4.5. Returns $2.40. Land Over Sea finishes second. Right There finishes third in the Chandelier. and now what used to be the old yellow ribbon, the Rodeo Drive.
Field sent on their mile and one quarter journey. They all appear to come out smoothly. Fantacola on the far side is showing early speed. Charlotte Ray in the pink colors right there too, and Stormy Lucy between these two. So those three go on to ensure a fast early pace out here. Then we drop back to Hard Not to Like, the gray tucked in behind them. Photo Call down at the rail. They've been followed by Famous Alice in the white cap. On the inside is Lady Pimpernel. It's another three lengths further back to Queen of the Sand, third last, and a good 12 off these leaders. Electrum to Content to sit back second last, and Star Act the trailer. Past the Sands first time round, and Fantacola's gone on to lead it just over a length. Stormy Lucy races in second. Charlotte Ray is now settled in the third spot. In behind that comes Photo Call, now five off the leaders. They've settled into just an even pace out on the lead. Then we have Hard Not to Like as the grey, being followed then by Lady Pimpernel, Famous Alice in the white cap. Electrum's travelling well, but a good eight lengths off the leader now, but they are taking closer order. Queen of the Sand in the red on the far side, and last of all is Star Act. They head to the half-mile pole, and Fantacola still got it all her own way. She leads just under two to Stormy Lucy. On the far side is Charlotte Ray in the third spot, and they've been followed by Photo Call. Hard Not to Like as four lengths off the leaders, then Lady Pimpernel. Now Electrum starts to make headway at the rail in the green. Probably biggest problem for Electrum now is where she's going to go. She's in behind a wall of horses. On the far side is Famous Alice. They are coming to the top of the lane now, and Fantacola kicks for home. Fantacola in front, taken on by Stormy Lucy. Photo Call looking for room desperately down at the rail. Electrum is chasing after them. On the outside, Charlotte Ray is also in there. They come for home, wide open now. Stormy Lucy, Photo Call, one from the rail. Electrum is flying late. They come for home, Photo Call. Photo Call coming home to win it. And Photo Call and Drayton Van Dyke, one at two. Electrum a little unlucky, probably got up for second. It is close though. Stormy Lucy, Fantacola right there too, and then Charlotte Ray.
Photo Call, an offspring of the ultra magnificent Galileo, scores the 2 1/4 length victory with Drayton Van Dyke in the saddle for Grand Motion. Ships out. Photo Call returns $19.40. Electrum finishes second, with Stormy Lucy nearly 25-1 finishing third. Hard Not to Like, recently seen at Saratoga, winning the Diana, the 8-5 favorite, finishes eighth. And wrapping up Saturday stakes action, the Awesome Again.
And away they go. Bayern hopped away smartly from the outside gate, goes straight to the front. Global View is showing speed back in the second spot on the outside. Here comes Smooth Roller now to take that second spot. Then back to Point Piper, Opportunity in the red colors, three lengths off the leader. They followed by Imperative, Hard Aces second last, and Sammy Mandeville Contend to trail early, is a good 10 off them. Into the turn they go, and Bayern out where he likes to be, showing the way at a sensible pace. Bayern a length and a half to Smooth Roller. Global View scrapes Payne third, and Opportunities on the far side. Right behind them comes Point Piper, who's 4.5 off the leader. Hard Aces at the back of the leading group, then a gap of 4 to Imperative, and Sammy Mandeville still the trailer, a good 12 off them. Down the back stretch they go, and Bayern now leads it by just over 2. Smooth Roller races in second, Opportunity on the far side. Global View is right there at the rail. Now there goes Hard Aces, and Hard Aces making ground has to go 4 wide, but Hard Aces all the way up to third. In behind those two comes Point Piper, big gap is 6 to Imperative and Sammy Mandeville. The rest of them bunch with 3/8 to go. Bayern is just in front, but coming under a ride. On the far side, Smooth Roller's now taken him on. It's 3 back to Opportunity. On the far side, Hard Aces made that run, but is flattening out a little now. Imperative is running on from behind. They're at the top of the lane, and Smooth Roller gets the lead. And Smooth Roller the one to beat. Bayern back in second, Opportunity in third. Past the 8th pole they come, and Smooth Roller goes on. Bayern is battling away in second, but Smooth Roller has his measure. And it's going to be Smooth Roller and Tyler Bay's impressive winners in today's Awesome Again Stakes. They win it easy. Opportunity second, Bayern held third. Then came Imperative, Point Piper. Behind that, Hard Aces, Sammy Mandeville, and Global View.
Watching this race unfold, I thought Smooth Roller was in brilliant position throughout the running for Tyler Bayes. Wins by 5.5, returns $13 even. The offspring of Hard Spun defeats Opportunity by Earn at 6-5 in what has been reported already as his final race. Boy, Byron at 4 years of age, boy, he just wasn't the same runner, it appears, as he was at three. And wrapping up the opening weekend stakes action from San Diego, the old Oak Tree Mile, now the City of Hope Mile.
And away they go. Telco was slow to get going.
Along the inside, Hot Hot Heat broke away well and goes for the lead. Here comes Avanzari to join now. Big Casanova in the pink colors right there too. Extreme outside is Alert Base. Alentio has the white cap. At the rail comes Posky. Big Bane Theory back of the leading group. And Telco is last. Seven lengths would cover the lot. They hit to the three-quarter pole, and Hot Hot Heat sets a sensible pace now, being joined by Big Casanova. Then it's three lengths back to Avanzari. Behind that comes Alert Bay. Down on the inside is Poshki in the black colors, now six off those leaders. Silentio, white cap towards the rear, then Big Bane Theory, and still Telco, the trailer, have got to be 10 off the leaders. They run to the half-mile pole, and Hot Hot Heat down at the rail. Big Casanova's keeping the pressure on. Those two stride along strongly now. They lead by three to Avanzari. On the far side comes Alert Bay in the pink colors. Silentio, white cap, Poshki at the rail. Telco starts to make headway now in the green colors. Telco's getting closer. Last of all, Big Bane Theory. Coming to the top of the lane, and Big Casanova now goes on. Avanzari's right there. Hot Hot Heat has folded. Between runners, Telco's coming of the run. Silentio on the far side, we have Alert Bay. Suddenly it's wide open. Big Casanova at the rail. Avanzari, white cap, Alert Bay on the outside. Telco continues to chase, and then Silentio. They come for home, and it's Alert Bay down the center of the track. Alert Bay, Big Casanova at the rail. Alert Bay, the advantage is there under the wire, and Alert Bay will win it. Alert Bay has won it. Big Casanova second, Avanzari third. Telco had to settle for fourth.
Alert Bay scores the victory, returning $10.80. Martin Garcia in the saddle. Blaine Wright trains. Big Casanova at nearly 20-1 finishes second. And Avanzari, the 8-5 favorite, finishes third in the City of Hope Mile. We're going to take a quick break. When we come back, the outstanding Saturday afternoon at Belmont Park.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
New York breads mean business for New York. Together with all horse-related businesses, we have a $4.2 billion impact on New York State's economy. And 33,000 people work full-time in the state's horse and racing industries.
I groom New York breads.
I gallop New York breads.
I shoe New York breads.
We breed New York breads.
Horse breeders in 50 New York counties pay millions in taxes while preserving farmland. New York breads, we mean business for New York.
Pick, bet, and cheer on world-class horse racing from Woodbine and Mohawk racetracks. Over 130 live thoroughbred days, over 200 live harness days, loads of action, tons of bet types. The guaranteed pick four, jackpot high five, and pick six bets are just the beginning. Join the ranks of Woodbine and Mohawk players from all over the globe and make your bets count. For more information on the latest updates on events and offers, visit woodbineentertainment.com.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, and amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off Exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. NYRA has scheduled two terrific Saturday afternoons in the fall. This past Saturday was the first one. Up first, Phillies and Bears in the Beldame.
They're off in the Beldame. And it was a good start for Wedding Toast, who came out very well. Hot Stones is right alongside of her early. These two out for the lead together. And they're being followed on the outside by Call Pat, who's closer to the pace today. Carolina's down on the inside, and then comes Catch My Drift. And House Rules trails six lengths off of front-running favorite Wedding Toast, who heads them up the backstretch through an easy opening quarter mile here of 24 seconds flat. And is pressed along by Hot Stones on the outside, who's now three-quarters of a length off of Wedding Toast. And Carolina's right behind them. Carolina's less than two lengths off the lead as well. And then it's a gap of another 2.5 to Call Pat, Catch My Drift. In hand second last year, leading only House Rules up the backstretch as they continue through the first half mile in 47-2. So it is Wedding Toast and Jose Lezcano in front. And they're on top a length and a half into the far turnover Hot Stones. And then it's Carolina to the inside third, trying to keep position there. And getting closer now is Catch My Drift. And Catch My Drift sent along by Arad Ortiz Jr. And she's edging up toward the front runners now with a three-wide run on the far turn. House Rules is next, and Call Pat's under a drive at the back of the field as Wedding Toast has run three-quarters in 111-1 and turns for home in the Beldame. Wedding Toast off the turn in front. Carolina is second now, and to the outside it's Catch My Drift as they come to the final furlong. Wedding Toast is set down with a three-length lead here. Carolina is clearly second, and then it's Catch My Drift, but there's no catching Wedding Toast. Wedding Toast, much the best here, all the way in the Beldame. Over Carolina, Catch My Drift, and Call Pat.
Wedding Toast, who has been brilliant at Belmont Park this year, scores the impressive front-end victory. Never had an anxious moment for Kieran McLaughlin. Jose Lezcano, the 3-5 favorite. The offspring of Street Sense returns $3.30, defeating the 3-year-old Carolina and finishing third, Catch My Drift. Up next, Phillies and Mariners sprinting in the Gallant Bloom.
They're off in the Gallant Bloom. Not a very good start for Dame Dorothy, who bobbled coming out of there. It's La Verdad who goes out to the front. Room for Me, Street Story, and Classic Point, all with speed, and Dame Dorothy sits right behind him on the rail, a length and a half off of La Verdad up the back stretch. And then Wavell Avenue, and the trailer is Willett. The field racing for the half-mile pole, La Verdad, pushed along by Room for Me through a 22-3 first quarter. And these two now a half length apart. Break of another two back to Dame Dorothy, who's taken third inside of Street Story on the turn. Classic Point follows in fifth. Wavell Avenue is sixth on the inside. 5.5 lengths off of La Verdad, and the trailer is Willett. So Jose Ortiz and La Verdad are making their way toward the top of the stretch in front. They went 45 flat for a half mile, Room for Me, and Dame Dorothy is down on the inside, and they're into the stretch. La Verdad off the turn in front. Room for Me is two lengths behind. Dame Dorothy has now moved up and takes second. La Verdad set down for a final furlong here, trying to hold off Dame Dorothy. And on the outside, Wavell Avenue is closing in too, but it's La Verdad, Wavell Avenue, La Verdad in the Gallant Bloom. Over Wavell Avenue, Dame Dorothy was third, and Room for Me was fourth.
And as you were watching the stakes action on East Coast, West Coast Saturday afternoon, boy, you saw many odds-on favorites. I think I counted 7 out of 12 races an odds-on favorite. Well, La Verdad doesn't disappoint. The 1-2 favorite for Linda Rice, Lady Sheila Stable, Jose Ortiz, scores the victory by half a length, returning $3.10, defeating the second longest shot on the board, Wavell Avenue. Dame Dorothy, who had a terrible, terrible start from the inside post position, finishes third in this year's Gallant Bloom. Now time for two-year-olds on the inner turf in the Pilgrim.
They're off in the Pilgrim. Pagan had a good start. Aid Milad's got speed. Next Shares on the outside. And farther out there goes Brass Compass now, up and after the front. And it's going to be Brass Compass and Next Shares to set the pace here. Pagan settles back running in third position, as are fourth. Aid Milad is fifth, and Forever in Love. Highland Sky is seven lengths off the lead early on, and then Isotherm, Raise the Bar, and Dissident trails the field. The first quarter in 24-1/5 seconds, and Next Shares and Joel Rosario lead the way up the back stretch. 3/4 of a length ahead of Brass Compass running in second. Pagan is third to the inside, Azar follows in fourth, Eid Milad, fifth right now, 4 lengths off the lead up the back stretch. Then Forever in Love to the outside, Highland Sky. Isotherm's got 8 lengths to make up just outside of Highland Sky. Raise the Bar and Dissident continues to race at the back, 48-1 for the first half mile. Next shares on top as the field rounds the far turn. Brass Compass a length and a half behind. Azar picks it up from third. Eid Milad has taken off the rail, goes up with Forever in Love, and they're charging up on the far turn. Isotherm has closed the gap to 4 lengths. Dissidents on the far outside. And then it is Highland Sky. Pagan has dropped back and raised the bar, and they're coming toward the top of the stretch. And it's next shares and Brass Compass turning for home in front. Forever in Love, Azar, and Eid Milad are all right there. Isotherm had to alter course there. So too did Highland Sky. No place to go for Raise the Bar, who's trying to squeeze on through toward the inside. Got through now. Here's Raise the Bar coming up the rail. Raise the Bar, Azar, Isotherm. These three down to the line. Isotherm won it. Azar and Raise the Bar. Highland Sky was fourth.
A sensational finish, often expected in turf racing, but Isotherm scores the neck victory. The runner for George Weaver, ridden by Jose Lescano, returns $21.20 for the neck victory. Azar, a neck in front of Raise the Bar, finishes second. And the European Import, a brilliant run along the hedge as the second choice in the wagering, finishes third. And regardless how the daily racing form spells it, there is an H in the Vosburgh.
They're off in the Vosburgh. And it's Wildcat Red who fires out for the lead with Weekend Hideaway and Palace in hot pursuit, second and third. Rockfall is fourth on the outside early on. Then it's Stalwalk and Dude, and they've separated themselves 6 lengths from Brothers of the Time and Salutos Amigos, who was a step slow to start here. Around the far turn, Wildcat Red, the leader, through an opening quarter mile in 22 1/5 seconds. And Weekend Hideaway goes with him, and Rockfall is third, and he's heading toward the front runners now. And Stalwalk and Dude is strong, and he's going up there 4 wide. And then it's Palace on the inside, saving all the ground and waiting in fifth. Salutos Amigos and Brothers of the Time. And they're coming toward the top of the stretch in the Vosburgh. Weekend Hideaway, Rockfall, Stalwalk and Dude, and Wildcat Red. A 45 1/2 mile. Now, Stalwalk and Dude and Rockfall are going at it. Salutos Amigos has moved up on the far outside. It is Rockfall, Stalwalk and Dude, Salutos Amigos on the outside. Palace down toward the rail. Rockfall, Stalwalk and Dude, Salutos Amigos, Rockfall won it! Salutos Amigos, Stalwalk and Dude, and Palace.
The 2-5 favorite, Rockfall. I think it's fair to say the leader in the clubhouse of the sprint division, Todd Pletcher, Stone Street, Javier Castellano. Rockfall looked in trouble at the top of the stretch, but Javier gets him to the line to finish a neck in front of Salutos Amigos. Stalwalk and Dude, who looked like a winner at the eighth pole, finishes third. Now back to the turf, ladies and gentlemen, the mile and a half Joe Hirsch Turf Classic.
They're off in the Joe Hirsch Turf Classic, and there goes Shining Copper up to grab the early lead. Shining Copper, as expected in that pacemaking role, has opened up to lead by 2.5 lengths in the early stages here. With Red Rifle away running in second, Twilight Eclipse third, and then comes Quiet Force to the outside, followed by Slumber, who's now 8 lengths off of Shining Copper. Big Blue Kitten is 12 lengths off of Shining Copper, and Perfect Title trails the field, and the pace is hot. 23-3, the opening quarter mile for this mile and a half distance, and Shining Copper doing what he does out there on an 8-length front-running mission on the clubhouse turn. Now it's almost a 10-length lead for Shining Copper. Red Rifle will let him go and sit second. Twilight Eclipse is third. And then comes Quiet Force, followed by Slumber. Break of another 3.5 lengths back to Big Blue Kitten, who's about 17 lengths off of his stablemate and leading only Perfect Title to the backstretch. 47 flat was the half mile. So they go on to this long backstretch here at Belmont Park with Shining Copper, the pacemaker, and in front by 7 lengths. heading up the back stretch. Red Rifle is second by four. Then it's Twilight Eclipse and Slumber on the outside. Another 3.5 back to Big Blue Kitten. And they're followed by Quiet Force and Perfect Title. So it has been Shining Copper all the way, three quarters up in 1, 11, and 2. And Shining Copper heads into the turn, and his lead is even bigger now. It's up to a 9-length advantage as they head round the turn. And Red Rifle is running in second. A Strong Slumber is third as they make their way around the turn. Twilight Eclipse being motivated for more as they catch up to Shining Copper now. Big Blue Kitten's within 6 lengths of the lead. It's still Shining Copper, but the lead is down to 1.5 lengths. Twilight Eclipse needs some running room. He's trapped in behind Shining Copper. No place to go for Twilight Eclipse. In the meanwhile, Big Blue Kitten rushes up on the outside. Joe Bravo says go to Big Blue Kitten, and they've opened up to lead by 2.5 lengths. With Slumber up running in second. Now there's late running room for Twilight Eclipse's third. Big Blue Kitten's got a 2.5-length lead. Slumber, Twilight Eclipse on the inside are coming. Big Blue Kitten, Slumber, Twilight Eclipse. Big Blue Kitten won the Joe Hirsch Turf Classic. It was a photo between Slumber and Twilight Eclipse behind him, and then it was Red Rifle and Shining Copper. And the final time was 2 minutes 23.39 seconds, a new course record.
And let it be said now, as I say often about records at a racetrack, now the rails are down, so I believe the teletimer, they dropped the rails for the first time in the fall meet. The fastest 1.5 miles ever run in New York is no longer held by Secretariat. Just goes to show you what track records are worth, because Big Blue Kitten shatters Sky Classic's track record, or course record as they apt want to say in turf racing, 2:23.39. Joe Bravo springs open the race, scores the victory for Chad Brown, wins his first Turf Classic. The Offspring of Kitten's Joy returns $7 even. Slumber finishes second. Twilight Eclipse, a rough trip around, finishes third. The 8-5 favorite, Red Rifle, finishes fourth. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, Sunday stakes action from Belmont Park.
Hey, race fans, head down to the all-new Clubhouse Racebook and get in the game. With live horse racing on more than 250 flat-screen TVs, state-of-the-art wagering terminals, fantastic food and drinks, an amazing Vegas-style atmosphere with seating for nearly 900 of your closest friends. Conveniently located at 711 Central Avenue, right off exit 5 of I-90 in Albany, the Clubhouse Racebook is the better choice.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV Digital Channel 8.2, delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world. Whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita racecourses, no other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Digital Channel 8.2.
New York breds mean business for New York. Together with all horse-related businesses, we have a $4.2 billion impact on New York State's economy. And 33,000 people work full-time in the state's horse and racing industries.
I groom New York breds.
I gallop New York breds.
I shoe New York breds.
We breed New York breds.
Horse breeders in 50 New York counties pay millions in taxes while preserving farmland. New York breds, we mean business for New York.
Face it. Most horse racing websites are just too much clutter, too much to navigate through. Next time, log on to CapitalOTB.com. Our newly designed website is easier than ever to use, with all the information the professional horse player needs. CapitalOTB.com.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Three juvenile stakes races on Sunday afternoon at Belmont Park. The first two for New York Breds. Up first, two-year-old fillies in the Joseph A. Jimma Stakes.
They're off in the Joseph A. Jimma, and Melodic had a good start from the far outside. There goes Surprise Cameo up to grab the lead, though. And Super Surprise takes up the chase and is into second. Frosty Margarita takes third. Melodic is back running in fourth now and taken in hand two lengths off the lead. Ben's Girl is last of the five. Up the backstretch, Surprise Cameo, Super Surprise, and Frosty Margarita. And these three together through a 23-flat opening quarter mile. Behind them is Melodic and Ben's Girl on the inside, four lengths off the lead. Surprise Cameo by a head on the far turn from Super Surprise and a three-wide Frosty Margarita. And now nothing separates these three on the lead. A length and a half to Melodic in fourth, and Ben's Girl continues to track at the back of the field after a 46.5 mile around the far turn. Frosty Margarita three-wide on the rail. Surprise Cameo, Super Surprise between those two, and Melodic looks to join them four wide, and they're at the top of the stretch here. And it is Frosty Margarita, Melodic on the far outside. Surprise Cameo and Super Surprise is given way to fourth, and they come into the final furlong, and Melodic has taken the lead. Melodic and Kendrick Carmouche, they are pulling away from Frosty Margarita, Surprise Cameo, and Super Surprise. Melodic wins the Joseph A. Gemma over Frosty Margarita. And there was Surprise Cameo, and Super Surprise was fourth.
Melodic scores the victory by three lengths with Kendrick Carmouche in the saddle. We saw this horse win the debut up at Saratoga for Leah Giramati. Wins by an impressive three lengths. Returns $7.10, defeating Frosty Margarita. Surprise Cameo finishes second, and the even money favorite, Super Surprise, finishes third. And keeping that surprise thought in mind, up next, two-year-olds in the Bond Guard.
They're off in the Bertram F. Bongard, and Sudden Surprise goes straight out to a two-length early lead. Champion of the Nile settles into stride in second. Get Jets is third to the inside, followed by Manipulated, and Steve's Image trails as the field heads up the backstretch. Sudden Surprise quick from the start, on top by a length and a half. Champion of the Nile getting a bit closer now, and Get Jets is third to the inside, and the first quarter goes in 23 4/5 seconds. An easy opening fraction here for Sudden Surprise in John Velasquez, and they're in front of Champion of the Nile by a length and a half. Now Steve's Image takes third outside of Get Jets, who's down at the rail, and Get Jets getting ridden along here by Errat Ortiz Jr., and then comes Manipulated last of them all. It is Sudden Surprise about a length in front here from Champion of the Nile, and Steve's Image is getting closer on the outside. Get Jets in behind horses. Manipulated's going to take the far outside path as they come toward the top of the stretch, the half in 47-1. Sudden Surprise turns for home in front. Champion of the Nile on the outside. Manipulated tries to close in. Get Jets is down toward the rail, a furlong to run. Sudden Surprise clings to the lead. Champion of the Nile, Get Jets closing the gap on the inside. Manipulated's on the far outside. Sudden Surprise, here comes Get Jets. These two will decide it. Sudden Surprise won it over Get Jets, and then came Champion of the Nile and Manipulated.
Sudden Surprise, the offspring of One and Done Giant Surprise, who ran for Mike Rapoli. This is a homebred from Mike Rapoli. Sudden Surprise scores the victory, making every poll a winning one. And what I must say, ladies and gentlemen, I don't have the history of the Bongard at the tip of my tongue or the forefront of my brain, but this had to be one of the best five field editions ever. Sudden Surprise returns $9.90 for Todd Pletcher and Johnny V. The 8-5 second choice, Get Jets, runs well. Champion of the Nile, the 6-5 favorite, not sent to the front from the outside, finishes third in what truly was a terrific renewal of the Bond Guard. Now time for two-year-old fillies on the turf open company. Remember that the boys ran on the inner turf on Saturday. The two-year-old fillies on the main turf with the rails down in the Miss Grillo.
They're off in the Miss Grillo, and a very slow start there for Archerella. A good beginning for Look Who's Talking. Chinchilla Dust on the outside away well. Then comes Thrilled and Lemon Liqueur. And it's two lengths more back to Tin Type Gal, who settles into stride running in fifth, 4.5 lengths off the lead, and just alongside of Wild About Harry as they enter the back stretch. Yanita is 7 lengths behind the pacemakers right now, clear of Time and Motion. Breakfast Time is second last. And Archerella, who just walked out of the gate, is some 14 lengths off the lead. The first quarter was up in 24 2/5 seconds. And it is Look Who's Talking in front. Chinchilla Dust pressing the issue, second on the outside by 4. And then comes Thrilled and Lemon Liqueur together, third and fourth. Tintype Gal follows in fifth. And Yanita to the inside, still about 8 or 9 lengths off the lead right now. Then Wild About Harry, Time and Motion's picking it up. And then comes Breakfast Time at Archerella. 48 1 was the half mile time. Look Who's Talking continues to be hounded up front by Chinchilla Dust. And now their noses apart, and they're 5 lengths ahead of the rest. And then it's Thrilled to the inside, running along in third position as they make their way around the far turn. Lemon Liqueur is next. Tintype Gal to the outside. Yanita's drawn within 4.5 lengths of the lead. Breakfast Time is on the far outside. Wild About Harry, Time and Motion cuts the corner, and they're into the stretch. And Look Who's Talking is still in front. Chinchilla Dust on the outside. Thrilled is coming up the rail. Here's Tintype Gal storming down the center of the course. Time and Motion is coming behind horses too. And Yanita's finishing fast on the far outside. Tintype Gal to the front. Tintype Gal, Thrilled fights on. These two down to the line. Tintype Gal beat Thrilled by a nose. Then Time and Motion and Yanita.
Tintype Gal wins the photo finish for Grand Motion. Luis Saez wins by a nose. The offspring of Tappet returns $9.70, defeating the second choice in the wagering. Thrilled. Time and Motion, the maiden for Jimmy Toner in the second career starts, finishes what I thought was a good third. The 2-1 favorite finishes fourth in this year's Miss Grillo. That wraps up this week's edition of H&C. Ladies and gentlemen, remember, another terrific weekend coming up for us. We have opening day at Keeneland for their fall meet as they get ready to host this year's Breeders' Cup. So enjoy your stakes action from around the country and join us next time for Horses and Courses.